Water is one of the world's most precious resources. Scientists say that you can live up to 100 hours without consuming water. There are now 7.6 billion people on Earth, and according to the United Nations, 2.1 billion people lack access to safely managed drinking water services. 4.5 billion lack safely managed sanitation services. Water scarcity impacts 4 out of every 10 people on the planet. And 80% of the world's wastewater flows back into the ecosystem without being treated or reused. On an island with no freshwater resources, how does the average Caymanian get fresh water to drink? Over the last 2 months here at the Cayman Compass, we've been conducting an investigation into where your water comes from and where it goes where you're done with it. We've done 2 site investigations at the facilities operated by Consolidated Water and by the Water Authority. And our goal was to find out how the whole process of desalination occurs, how they make sure and know how much water they need to service 50,000 people here in the Cayman Islands. And what happens to your water when you're done with it? How they keep the wastewater from going back into the same exact place of the well that you drink your drinking water from. I invite you to watch our video and to read the story and to learn a little bit more about where your drinking water comes from and where it goes when you're done with it. To understand how we get the water here in Cayman, we went to speak with Manuel Tomas, the general manager of Cayman Water. What you showed us here today.
All right, so we did a tour to the origins of water, and we followed all the path of the water until it gets to the tap water. So basically, we get the water out of wells, we get salty water, very salty water, but because it comes from wells and not from open sea, it's good quality. So you don't have a lot of dirt and algae and rocks and nothing is there. So we take that water and then we pre-filtered it. So with 5 micron filters, so we get all the small particles out of the water. That water goes into the desal plant. Basically, what we do with that water, we pressurize that water. That water goes through semi-permeable membranes, and part of that water goes to the other side of the membrane as potable water. So salt-free water, basically. 40% of that water is potable water. We take that potable water, we degas it, so we take the H2S, so the hydrogen sulfide, out of it. That's a thing that we have to do in the Cayman Island because of the geology of the soil where we get the water from. It comes with H2S, so we have to take it out. Then we adjust the pH, we add chlorine to disinfect the water, and we send it to the storage. Then it goes straight to the network when it's needed. So basically, we regulate the amount of water that goes to the network as it's needed. It's there to be used, okay? The reject water, so we use part of the energy, but the water itself, unpressurized, because we took the energy, the pressure, to the feed line, it goes to the disposal well, and it goes to the sea again, I guess. So basically, it's how it works. We can really produce highly potable water out of seawater with this technology in the Cayman Islands. All of the water that's supplied in a public service utility by public service utilities is desal because you don't have fresh water underground, you don't have rivers, we don't have plants, so it means that we have to take what we have, and we have plenty of seawater just around us. So that's basically what we do here. Cayman water has a loss that it's below 10%, and that's really a worldwide benchmark. You don't have many utilities around the world with losses below 10%. We are searching for even lower losses. There will always be what we call the unavoidable losses, so we can't go below that. We think that we are pretty much almost at the economical level of losses. So below that, it's not economical. It's gonna be maybe 7.5%. So we are just almost close to that. So we think that Cayman Water, in terms of water losses management, is doing pretty, pretty good.
And in the grand scheme of the world, it's doing
right, yeah, yeah. Exactly. Well, definitely. I mean, if you look at the other Caribbean islands, I mean, there's nothing that compares to Cayman Island. Nothing, nothing. We're talking about more than 40, 50, 60% in some cases. So this is really a case study for the Caribbean, certainly. But even for worldwide utilities, you don't have a lot that have this low volume of losses. Sure. So it's a good, good benchmark for Cayman Water, definitely.
So now that we've investigated where the fresh potable water comes from, we went to the Cayman Water Authority to find out where the wastewater goes after you flush the toilet.
What's the difference between like water that people would drink and water that people would use to bathe in?
It's
the same exact water?
It's the exact same. So, and it's something that I think a lot of people are not necessarily aware of, the fact that the water that is supplied to them by the Water Authority is potable water. So the standards of our drinking water actually exceed the standards set by the World Health Organization. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a dedicated lab. Our lab was actually the first of its kind in the Caribbean to be internationally accredited. Mm-hmm. So it maintains its accreditation with the American Association for Laboratory Accreditation, which is A2LA. And they became certified in 2002. And they're audited internally every year and externally every 2 years. And they are responsible, they have a number of responsibilities under the authority. One of them, and the one that I think people are usually most concerned about, is that the water, the safety of the water that we produce. So they are responsible for testing the water we produce to make sure that it fits within the guidelines, that all the levels of chemicals are where they're supposed to be, and that the water is safe to drink.
Sure.
We have 25 taps throughout the island, and the water is tested. So after it leaves the RO plant, after it leaves the storage plants, and then we have random sample taps throughout the island that are tested, some daily and then others on a rotational basis. And those are tested to make sure that, again, there's no problems throughout the distribution network.
You know, people know when they turn the faucet on, when they faucet off, but they have no idea what happens to the water that goes down the sink afterwards.
Yeah, absolutely. Basically, we have, there's two sides of the wastewater issue as well. About 20% of the wastewater produced in Cayman goes to the wastewater treatment plant that is owned and operated by the Water Authority. It's located by the dump.
Okay.
And the rest of that is dealt with through on-site wastewater treatment, which if a development produces under 1,800 US gallons of wastewater per day, then that can be a septic tank. So that's like a small house, that's not anything multi-residential.
Sure.
And all commercial facilities have different requirements. But if we're talking about like a residential property, if it produces less than 1,800 US gallons of wastewater per day, it can have a septic tank. So most condo complexes will have an ATU or a package plant. Like the authority has one. So anything that's producing over that level has to have its own wastewater treatment system.
And what's that do? It just cycles the water until it's clean?
No, the wastewater treatment plant that we have and the aerobic treatment units are really cool because they're completely biological. They use aerobic bacteria to break down the waste.
Oh wow.
So our wastewater treatment unit plant, I think, goes through 2.2 to 2.3 million gallons of wastewater every day.
Wow.
And so the bacteria in those, we call them, they're sequence batch reactors. The bacteria in those sequence batch reactors eat the caloric equivalent of about 20,000 Big Macs.
Wow, those are hungry bacteria.
Yeah, yeah. So it's completely biological. The wastewater treatment plant was initially made operational in 1988, but then it was waste stabilization pools, which basically use sunlight to treat wastewater. It's highly effective, but it takes a long time. So in 2005, and because of the amount of wastewater that was being sent to the wastewater treatment plant, we needed to expand to a different, to a more efficient system of treatment. And in 2005, that's when the sequence batch reactors were opened.
And then does that water wind up getting recycled at some point?
The thing is that all water ends up getting recycled at some point. So the long-term answer is yes, because, I mean, the amount of water that exists on Earth is the same amount of water that existed on Earth when dinosaurs were here.
Huh.
So we're using the same water over and over and over again.
Right.
And it's something that obviously is becoming of greater interest to countries around the world because of the potential for wastewater reuse, especially in water-scarce countries. So it's not something that we currently use in Cayman. We don't currently reuse the wastewater, but it is something that is drawing a lot of attention in other countries.